For millions of years, the mountains have stood high against all odds. But are they actually impregnable and invincible as we think? Scientific research has proved that they are as vulnerable as the world's oceans, grasslands, and forests. Scientists have been constantly warning about the meltdown of huge masses of ice in the mountains due to global warming, the direct impact of which is on the glaciers. In Nepal, we have not yet taken the issue of global warming seriously, but ours is one of the countries mostly at risk. I went on a tour to the Everest region to learn how global warming has been badly affecting our mountain areas. Sandeep Rai, climate change officer from WWF-Nepal, will be guiding me throughout the trip where we will witness the consequences of global warming. This is not going to be an easy trip for me as it is my first trek. We'll be walking for another 8 days to reach Imja Lake. We will witness how global warming has melted the glaciers rapidly and created a huge lake. Glaciers in our mountain areas are already shrinking and turning into huge lakes. The size of glacier lakes is growing and only the mud walls of the lakes are blocking the water from bursting out. But as more glaciers melt, the water level will keep on increasing and the moraine dams will not be able to hold the water. Once the water breaks through the walls, the lake water will turn into a colossal flood that will rush downhill to the villages. After almost 3 hours, we managed to reach Ghat village. This village was torn apart by the glacial lake outburst flood in 1985 when the moraine walls of Tsho lake broke down. The force of the flood from Tsho lake was so immense that it rushed about 90 kilometers downstream, destroying everything in its way, even cutting through the hills and forming gorges. Nawa Jikter is a senior monk in his village. 19 years back, he had witnessed the flood destroy his village. He saw his own house fall apart. He just watched in despair as all his cows drowned in the raging water. He recalls that dreadful day.
यहाँ कति टेमा आयो भने दिउँसोको 4 बजेको टेमा आयो अनि राति भएदेखि त हामीहरु पनि नबज्न रहेछ तर मतिबाट दुर भनेर करायो अनि भयरमा निसेर हेर्दाखेरि मतिबाट यसो गरेर डुङ्गा पानी डर यसो गरेर कारसँग भिरेर आउँदै रहेछ.
It took us almost 12 hours to reach Namse Bazar, which lies at an altitude of 3,450 meters. Namche Bazar is the resting camp from where it is necessary for all the trekkers to acclimatize themselves so that they don't suffer from altitude sickness. Here, people have no fear of glacial lake floods, landslides or avalanches. But several Everest climbers are quite concerned over global warming, especially the impact on glaciers that are receding rapidly in the last few decades. We met Nima Tashi Sherpa, an expert mountain climber who has summited Mount Everest more than 8 times. He has been working as a mountain climbing guide for the last 20 years. He explains how the situation in Everest region has changed. Up from Namche, the flow of fresh water is seen almost in every direction. Water from the mountains is a vital source of drinking water for more than 2 billion people around the world. The glacier meltwater produces the lifeblood of fresh water for Ganga, Brahmaputra, Indus and many other great South Asian rivers upon which hundreds of millions of people depend. Without glacier meltwater, many lakes and rivers could dry up. After 9 hours from Namche, we reached Tengboche. Here, we will be meeting the Rinpoche, the senior most spiritual leader of Khumbu region. We talked to him about several issues related to global warming. He was mainly concerned about the effect of global warming on the fresh water supply. This is Pangboche, where remains of the landslide that occurred more than two decades back are still there. These huge scars on the landscape are the reminders of how the mountain regions are being damaged by the sudden glacial floods from the lakes. It's almost 6 in the evening and it's getting very cold. The more we climbed up, the more our walking pace slowed down. I was so tired then. I was beginning to feel sick as well. The destructive sights of the hills made me much worse. This scar on the hill of Dingboche Valley is a constant reminder of the dreadful night in 1986 when the flood from Amadablam Glacier rushed down and caused a huge destruction. We walked around the village to interview the local residents about the incident. As a coincidence, we met Dorje Sherpa and his wife who told us about the tragic night.
Kedala, Tori, Argo Admin Dizana, Argo Elda, Chosen Moro.
We are now in Chukum and I'm surrounded by mountains as you can see here. After a while we'll be taking up the hard trail to Imja. I managed to reach up to here. I think I still have some energy left to walk up towards the lake. As we walked over the vast stretch of grassland, we realized that this is the same route where the flood could come down rushing from Imja Lake and attack Chukum, first destroying the small settlement down there. Now we are getting close. We can already see the lake from here. The lake seems massive, much larger than we had imagined. It is hard to believe that all this used to be glaciers. By 1960, most of the glacier melted and turned into a lake. The lake is growing as more glaciers are retreating fast and melting at the rate of nearly 10 meters every year. We were successful to witness the direct impact of global warming on the glaciers. Now we had to see what happens when the glacial lake bursts out of the moraine walls. We decided to go to Tsho Lake from where the flood was unleashed. At Thamu, we met Ang Maya Sherpa who had witnessed the destructive flood when she was just a teenager. She offered to show us all the hills and villages destroyed by the flood. The flood had killed about 5 people and had destroyed several bridges. The roads were cut off for 2 months. All the farms were washed away. The Namje Hydro project, which was worth about 1.5 million, was completely destroyed. This is just the tip of the problem caused by global warming. It is quite sad to think that all these beautiful glaciers, formed by more than 2 million years of snowfall, are receding faster in the Himalayas than anywhere in the world. Going to the glacier area was certainly the best educational journey for me to understand how global warming has directly affected our country. But I was certainly very depressed to see the reality there. Although Nepal has a minuscule share in the global warming, our country has to bear the impact of the problem made worse by the developed nations of the West.